So here we're in front of like a little bit the beginning of the show in a sense too, when you come up the stairs. And this is one of the more, it's rather an iconic work in the oeuvre I've built up. It's one from 1990. And it's also made with a specific technique, because underneath the layer of paint, I used a certain medium that sort of produces a craquelé or cracks in the paint prematurely, so that it actually looked aged already when it was made in the 90s. So this was rather on purpose. What you actually see is a doll that I had in my infancy, but also in my studio still, which was actually made out of cloth and a porcelain head, which you don't see. You also don't see the sex. I mean, it could be male, female, but there is no real sex, actually. But actually, what takes the place of a face is actually the body itself, and the zipper, which is actually nearly a sort of mutilated element or as a scar in the image. You can open it up, stuff it, and make it come alive. So in the very, very, very first beginning, there was a clear statement in terms to look at things as objects and also to perceive them as such within a very determined space where they could become actually, although being, as I said, banal, left over, they could become also rather violent in a sense. Because this violence also, of course, emanates the idea of a supposed mutilation which is or is not there. But it's also quite important because you can see the difference, and this is something that the show will also prevail you with the trajectory in time and the difference between all the paintings. Because although I work from represented image, it's very important for me to know what it is, what it means, in order for me to have the kick to actually convince myself to paint it. And on the other hand, what is also important, once I know what I'm going to paint, I also sort of like figure out how I'm going to paint it. So that is, there is a difference between most of the paintings in these shows. Because what's also interesting is that from the start, as I said, there was not an idea of a retrospective or a linear apprehension of a show in terms of time, but actually to make a mixture between actually very recent works, and this is one of the spaces that does that, and actually older works, but in a very punctuated way, so that they actually make a juxtaposition and go into a dialogue with each other. I think that is also one of the things that was a sort of idea to set out to do this in this space, because the space itself is also already, as I said, rather classical, but it's also not a white cube. So you have to make it actually more comprehensive in a sense, but also more complicated. So this painting, although small, has this, sets the tone in terms of that I always set from the beginning, that the underlying tone of the work is actually violence. So, but it is actually the type of violence I actually perceive as violence, not so much the action of violence itself, but actually the trace of it or something that is as a leftover actually there.